planning in India, and we have covered a lot of background and meanings and concepts, everything. I hope that we were here. Central focal themes. I hope we have covered this point.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Now there was a 12-fire plan, although it is not very important right now, but just I want to tell you what was the scenario of last fire plan, that is 12-fire plan. This is for the first time that one single plan had three different range of targets. Due to that political uncertainty and so many things were there, economic uncertainty. And there were some disturbance in parliament also, that all these things were happening that time. And that background, the Planning Commission had decided to put three different targets with reference to three different scenario. The first was aspirational scenario. It means if economy and political system will remain supportive, then the target was to have a strong inclusive growth of 8% per annum. Second scenario was if strong action were not possible and only insufficient action will be there, then growth rate may be declined to 6.5 to 7% per annum. And the third and lowest objective was if there is continuous hindrances to policy actions, means known as policy logjam, if parliament is not allowed to run, if decisions are not allowed to be taken, then in that situation, the growth rate may further decline to 5 to 5.5% per annum. These were three different scenarios in view of so many political, economic dimensions and obstacles at that time. Although this, now we are not discussing much for that, which plan is already over, and that was the last fire plan. Then, since India has gone through 12 plans, and after 12 plans, we had no planning right now because we have discussed already. The NITI Aayog has disbanded the fire planning system, and in place of that, we have three different planning scenarios, not fire plan. So, what happened in different plans? I have just presented a chart that is targets and actuals of different fire plans. And after 12 plan, we have witnessed four more years, that is 17, 18, 18, 19, 19, 20, and 2021. And out of these last 2 years were the time of COVID-19, difficult for globe and India also. And we have very low growth rate, and especially 2021, we had witnessed a negative growth rate of minus 7.3%. And the highest growth rate during the plan era was witnessed in 11th fire plan, that was 8% per annum. The 11th plan had highest target also and highest growth, actual growth also. 9% was the target and 8% was the actual growth. In view of 8% growth rate that he had achieved in 11th plan, the Planning Commission decided to have 8% growth target for next plan also, but actual growth rate was a little lower. That is 7.1%. That is also a very impressive growth rate. That is 7% and above. That is impressive growth rate. And if you look at the 10th plan, 11th plan, and 12th plan, all these three plans, you will see that in all three plans, 10th, 11th, and 12th, इंडिया हैड अचीव्ड 7% प्लस ग्रोथ रेट. दैट वी विल ऑल्सो रेफर व्हेन वी डिस्कस अ हिंदू ग्रोथ रेट. एट दैट टाइम आई विल हैव सम मोर आइडियाज अबाउट व्हाई आई एम मेंशनिंग 7% प्लस ग्रोथ रेट एज अ मोर इंपॉर्टेंट ग्रोथ रेट ऑल्सो. This is only the data part that I'm presenting you so that we can have an idea what happened during planning era in India, especially growth scenario, and after that also during last 4 years. You know that we have discussed already that 12 plan was the last plan which ended at 2016-17, and thereafter we have four annual plans: 17-18, 18-19, 19-20, 2021, and pass through some difficult economic situation also. Then when we're talking about the 12 plan that witnessed 7.1% growth rate with target of 8%, and I mentioned it earlier also, these targets and actuals are actually average of 5 years. And that I have mentioned here also, how different years during 12 fire plans had their own targets and what were the actual achievement for each year. And when you look at these 5 years separately, you can have a good idea about the annual target and annual actual. And finally, you can have the 5 year target and 5 year actual also. This is how we calculate the growth rate. That is like we say it is annual average growth rate as target and annual average growth rate as actual, both. So both are actual and target, annual average. Now, we had so many types of planning. There are so many concepts of planning. I mentioned a few important concepts of planning. We just go through all these terminologies, and if you have any question in your mind, just tell me so that I can discuss that particular point in a little detail.
So point number third.
Indicative. Indicative, I believe
imperative.
We have discussed earlier. Third is indicative, but I believe that we have discussed a lot. Just see here, we have discussed in detail when we were discussing eighth plan onwards. That is the, if you see bold letters, indication. I mentioned that time also. Now we have indicative planning. That is indication, coordination, and prescription. Do you remember, or should I tell you again? Tell me whether you have any question in doubt, I just tell you.
Sir, rolling plan.
Rolling plan. Okay. Any other? We have discussed indicative plan. Gandhian also. Okay.
Sir, imperative plan.
Means I believe that we should very briefly discuss each and every point. Very briefly. Otherwise, it will take a lot of time. If I discuss in detail each
yes,
plan,
sir.
It will take a lot of time.
Now, yes, sir.
Very briefly, I will just mention you so that if you have doubt, then we can discuss in that in detail. Now, periodic plan means when any plan has a specific time period, that is from starting point to finishing point duration is fixed, a given period. It can be any period. When we say that India had adopted a 5 year time period, or as you can say, it was a medium term or medium period plan. That is called periodic plan. Simply, that is when a specific time period has been decided for a plan. I had told you earlier also, although India had adopted a medium time period plan, that is 5 year plan, but each plan was further segregated into 5 annual plan periods also. And I had mentioned what was the reason behind segregating 1 5 year plan into 5 annual plan components. If you remember, I have told you that there are two main reasons. One was our budget is always annual. And number two, segregating a 5 year time period into 5 annual plans gives the planning system much desired flexibility of continuous assessment, adjustment, and readjustment process. That is known as periodic plan. Because when we talk about period, we say it can be a short period plan, it can be medium period plan, it can be long period plan, or it can be very long period plan also. When we say very long period plan, it means it is 10 years or more. It can be very long period. Short period means simply 1 year. Medium term plan means single digit of medium level. It can be 4 years, it can be 5 years, it can be 6 years. But India had adopted 5 year plan that we have discussed earlier also. If it is a little longer time, which goes up to 10 years, it can be a long term plan. And it goes more than 10 years, suppose it goes in decades. It can be a very long-term plan also. Very long-term plan is also part of long-term plan. I hope the term periodic plan is clear to you now. If still you have any question, please don't hesitate to ask me so that I can have a more detailed about that point also. Now, second is perspective plan. I had mentioned perspective plan also, but I'm again coming to that. When we say ki India had adopted a medium term plan of 5 years, and we know that each plan contains number of objectives, and some of these objectives are of short term of nature, some of objectives are medium term of nature, and some objectives are long term and very long term in nature. And most interesting is that the long term objectives within a medium term plan are actually very important objectives. Because these objectives are of such magnitude that it is not possible to achieve those objectives within a medium term or short term time period. I can give you many examples. For example, suppose we say self-sufficiency. If we say poverty eradication, if we say population stabilization, I've given a couple of examples. Do you think that these objectives can be fulfilled within 5 years or a still smaller time duration?
No, sir.
Then what can we do? It means to achieve these objectives, which are of long term of nature, we have to take steps right now so that finally we can reach that goal. Whatever we are doing in 1 year 2 year or 3 year, actually these steps, these actions are targeted towards a long-term goal. Now, very simple sentence. Perspective planning means short-term plans in long-term perspective or long-term objective. Means our perspective is long, vision is long-term, but we are taking small steps, short-term planning, annual planning, so that each year we can achieve a little part of that long-term goal. That is known as perspective planning. Actually, perspective planning is very important because it ensures to fulfill our secured future goals. We decide today our actions, but actually our targets are of long time period. That is, the perspective is wide, steps are small. We take small steps towards a long-term goal. That is known as perspective planning. And this is always very important. And it was so important that when we had planning commission, there was within planning commission, there was a perspective plan department. Because in context of perspective plan, long-term vision, we used to frame 5 year plans, and within 5 year plans, we used to frame our annual planning structure also. The perspective goals means long-term goals, and perspective plan means long-term planning, for which we are taking medium-term or short-term steps. So that we have a secure future, what we desire for our nation in a long-term perspective. And this is always in news. If you remember last month, when there was Glasgow conference, Glasgow, that is UNFCCC, COP26, that you all must have noticed, then India decided that we'll achieve net zero emission target by 2070. 2070 means 50 years from now. That is our perspective plan. Taking short-term steps for long-term objectives. In a most simple words, that is known as perspective plan. I believe it is very simple now. What is perspective? What is importance? Next is indicative plan. As you asked me, what is indicative plan? I had mentioned earlier also that when India adopted the 8th Plenary Plan, it was a different plan. We had some planning reforms also at that time. You remember, 8th plan means 1992 onwards. And we had discussed very long that what happened during 90 and 92, 2 years. You remember everything we had discussed in detail. Then India adopted a path of economic liberalization, economic reforms, privatization, globalization, everything we have mentioned in detail, in which government decided to decrease its economic role and increase the role of private sector. At that time, we were discussing, the question was the market versus plan. And I had told you a very interesting quotation from the preface of the 8th plan by P.B. Narasimha Rao, that market may lead to a situation of equilibrium between demand and supply. But it cannot ensure a balance between need and supply, and that's why we need still planning. It's still very important. But in the new scenario, the new economy of India, the planning will be indicative in nature, that there will be no compulsion. There are only promotion, incentives to the economic participants, so that the private sector also takes decisions in favor of socio-economic objectives. I had mentioned one sentence that now the Planning Commission said that whereas the market will ensure efficiency, the planning will be long-term guiding force to indicate, to show the path through the incentives, fiscal incentives, monetary incentives, various incentives, so that economic decisions are taken in favor of the objectives of plan. That is what is the indicative plan. No compulsion, but only indication, only motivation, only incentives, so that private and public sector combine together and they become so dovetailed that one becomes complementary for the other. And through this complement, togetherness, finally we are able to achieve our desired socio-economic goals. That is known as indicative planning. This was a term which was used for the first time in our eighth five-year plan. That you know the story, history of eighth plan, I had discussed in detail when we are discussing different time periods of different plans. And this term actually was adopted from the French planning system, France. From France, we adopted the indicative planning for India, where role of market will be increasing, but along with the coordination between different sectors, between private and public sectors, etc. That is known as indicative planning. Means giving a desired direction, showing a desired path to the private sector also, so that private sector moves in desired direction for fulfilling the objectives of the plan. I hope now it is simple for you what is indicative. To indicate, to show the path, and giving various types of incentives so that the economic actions move towards that path which government or which planning commission desires, so that that path will ultimately lead to our desired objectives. That is a new system of planning in mixed economy of India that we initiated since eighth five-year plan. Now next is imperative plan. Imperative plan is actually a plan where the government has a dominant role, where central planning authority play the most important role. The planning authorities control the resources, they decide the framework of plan, they decide the targets, they allocate the resources, means everything in the system, economic system, moves as desired by the central planning authority. There is no freedom at different levels. Means planning is decided by the central planning authority, and that is given to all the participants to activate the plan. You can say that imperative planning is also a planning by order, and you have to obey the order. Planning by direction, you have been directed to take actions as decided by the most powerful authority of the country. Basically, imperative planning is a system of planning where there is a strong political ruler who rules the system as per his own decisions. You can say authoritarian type of planning, when your single authority has everything to decide. I hope it is simple. Now, next two are very interesting, that is centralized and decentralized, totally opposite to each other. A centralized planning is also known as planning from top. We are planning from above, where the planning decisions are taken by the planning body at the top level, and those decisions percolate down, move down to the different tiers of the economy. Basically, centralized planning is a planning system of, you can say, socialist countries or communist countries. That is known as centralized planning. And just opposite, decentralized planning, which is known as planning from below. Centralized was planning from top or planning from above. Decentralized means planning from below, where planning decisions are taken at the grassroots level. And from those suggestions, those decisions ultimately reach the upper levels and they are finalized. In decentralized planning, the elected representatives at different levels also have their voice. Even common men also have their voice to suggest to the planning authorities that what should be the structure of planning. And when we had the planning, in initial planning years, we were little more centralized type of planning, but especially seventh plan onwards. And more especially when India had 73rd and 74th amendments to the Constitution, when we introduced the local bodies, that is rural local bodies and urban local bodies, it became more and more decentralized. As we had a planning commission, National Planning Commission, then we had state planning commissions in every states, and we had Panchayati Raj system, PRIs, and urban local bodies to decide the district level decisions also. Naturally, they all will be in light of the national planning. The national planning is also formulated based on the decisions, suggestions, consultancy with different levels of people and elected representatives. The basic structure of India's planning was decentralized. And same is now what we are having right now through Niti Aayog that I will discuss little later. I am giving a very, very brief idea of each every term. If you have any doubt, any question, then please raise the question so that we can discuss it a little wider. Now, next is a rolling plan. Rolling plan, you can say in other simple words, that is continuous plan. That is rolling or continuous. This is the concept which was given by Gunnar Myrdal. I hope you all know the name of Gunnar Myrdal. And one of his books, Asian Drama, is very famous, Asian Drama by Gunnar Myrdal. Now, Gunnar Myrdal had suggested that rolling planning system will be more useful for developing countries, including India. Now, just understand what is the concept of rolling planning. Rolling plan means that when every year we formulate three plans, every year three plans are formulated covering different time periods. One plan is short term, that is annual plan, based on the budget and foreign exchange reserve situation. One plan is annual plan. Then one plan is medium term plan. Say, for example, fire plan, which contains medium term objectives and steps. And one plan is long term plan. Say, for example, say 15 years. So every year we decide three plans. In my example, one is annual plan, 1 year, second is medium term plan, 5 years, and third is long term plan, say 15 years, or you can say 10 years, whatever you decide. Now, when 1 year is over, the short term plan is over, we evaluate that plan and delete that plan. Delete that plan. And again, we have three plans. That is, now we have again one annual plan. Again, we have one fire plan. Again, we have one long-term plan. It means 1 year has been deleted. And one more year or one new year has been added to make it again 15, 5, and 1. Suppose, for example, it was 1 year, 5 or 15 years, ranging from year 1 to year 15. Now, when 1 year is over, we delete 1 year. That is, number 1 is over. Now we start from 2, but add one more, that is 16. So next 15 will be 2 to 16. 2 will be then 1 year, 2 to 6 will be medium year, and 2 to 16 will be long term. Suppose one more year is over, year 2 is over. Again, we review, delete that year. Now year 3 will be 1 year plan, 3 to 7 will be medium term plan. and 3 to 17 will be the long-term plan. It means without completion of 5-year or 15-year fixed time period, we keep on adding and keep on deleting. We keep on rolling forward. Delete. Past years are rolled and more years are added. And that means before completion of 1 5-year plan or 1 15-year plan, we fulfill a part of it, but add a part of next also. That is why I told you it is a continuous planning or rolling planning. If you remember, India had experimented with the rolling planning system when we had so many structural change during 5th and 6th plan period, specifically 1978 to 1980, Janata Party government, if you remember. I told you in detail what happened when Morarji Desai became the Prime Minister, Janata Party government. Fifth plan was cut down to 4 years without completion. Next plan was rolled, sixth plan from 78 to 83. And before that rolling plan was completed, again, Mrs. Gandhi came back to power, she cut down that plan for after 2 years. 1 year was added to fifth plan, 1 year was added as annual, and then we had a new plan from 80 to 85, sixth plan. So that those 2 years, that is 78 to 80, were what we decided as part of fifth and one annual. Actually, that time period was rolling plan time period, 2 years of rolling plan in India. If you remember, then it is okay. Or if you have any question, then I will tell you again. But that day also, I ask you to please note down all the time periods. Then you can understand what happened during that time, specifically when I'm discussing the Janata Party government and Congress government planning system. Any doubt, any question? This complete silence from your side. I don't know whether you are able to understand or not, because I'm moving a little swiftly. Am I audible or not? I'm not getting any voice from your side.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
No, any problem? Are you getting what I'm just right now telling you? Yeah, it is clear everything?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay, yes, sir. Okay. Okay. Then next two again are a structural plan and functional plan. A structural plan means when the central objective of the planning system is to change. To change the existing structure of economy so that we can replace the existing structure by a new structure. Means plan aims to have structural changes. Why? Because we believe that existing structure is not very conducive for overall socio-economic development. It creates obstacles to move toward desired goals. And we want to replace the old structure and adopt a new structure. If our planning is like that, then we say it is structural planning. In simplest words, structural planning seeks to change the existing socio-economic structure of the country because it is believed that existing structure is not supportive to socio-economic goals. Therefore, we should have new structure of the economy so that rapid development and rapid growth can be ensured. I hope you understand this point. Let me first discuss second one also, then I will ask you some question. The next one is functional planning, which means a plan which does not want to change the existing structure, but the existing structure is retained as it is, or some specific steps are initiated to make that existing structure more strong. Just repair its shortcomings, just to add something new, so that the existing structure functions in a more effective manner. Means same structure is retained to function. The structure is not changed because it is believed that existing structure is good and there is no need to change it, just to have some repairs, some oiling for its smooth functioning. I hope you understand the contrast between structural and functional. Both are just opposite to each other. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Now tell me, what type of planning out of these two is for India? It can either be structural or functional. We can't have both simultaneously. So what is the nature of Indian planning, whether it is structural or functional? As I told you, whether it is indicative or imperative, that we have indicative. Whether centralized, decentralized, we have decentralized. These all two words are very contrast to each other. In the same fashion, I'm asking you whether India's planning is structural or functional in nature.
Functional.
Functional. Now, one answer is functional. There can be second answer also, but there is only one answer.
Functional, sir. Functional.
Functional.
Functional, sir.
All. So there, I can understand, hear two, three, four voices, but everybody says functional, and functional planning is the wrong answer. Totally wrong answer. Tell me, just tell me, do you think that the existing structure of the economy and the planning steps are conducive, best supportive to the economic growth and development?
No, sir.
Then how can it be functional then? I told you, basic difference between structural and functional means, structural means when the ultimate objective is to change the existing structure. And functional means goal is to retain the existing structure. Just give a serious thinking. When I told you right now that after 90s, India moved toward new economy. I just told you new economy. It means total structural change. We had de-licensing. We had cut down the size of private public sector. We had opening up a boundary for foreign investment. We started doing away with all the obstacles, diluting the rules and regulations and acts, so that economy moved to a totally new structure. That was the structural planning, and still we are changing our structure. There are so many big examples. You can see in simplest manner, for your example, structural change in our indirect taxation system, a totally new structure of goods and services tax, GST, we had adopted because we are not satisfied with our old tax structure. We have opened, allowed the private sector investors to invest in India's defense industry. 100% private investment is now allowed in defense. It is totally new structure. We have started in a big way disinvestment, in a decreasing government shareholding in public sector companies. Totally new structure. We have started in a big way merger of public sector banks. It is a new structure. In all walks of life, in all the sectors, you can say rapid structural change. We believed that old structure was not supportive of our long-term growth and development. Whatever growth rate, high growth rate you are experiencing for India right now, especially since economic reforms in India, this is all because of structural change we adopted specifically since 1990s onwards for India. And the best example for you is right now that we have changed the structure of planning also. We don't have a fixed time period fire plans in India right now. We don't have planning commission right now. That is the best example for you to just believe. And what was the need to replace planning commission by Niti Aayog? This is a very good example of structural change. The entire planning system has been changed. Total structure of economy has been country. But we have some specific plans for specific regions also. If you remember, we have so many programs and incentives and plannings for different regions also. For example, we have Northeast Council. For Northeast area only. We have border area development program for border areas only. We have coastal regions plan for coastal areas only. We have backward area development system for backward areas only. We have a specific program for hills and difficult terrains of the country also. We have desert development program for deserts only. I hope it is simple now. The regional planning means when within national plan, we have specific components of planning, focusing on different regions so that ultimately we can achieve a balanced regional development. Otherwise, some regions will remain backward. Some regions will become high developed regions, and that is not good for the economy. So regional planning is basically to ensure a balanced regional development of the country. And for that, we adopt different types of planning for different regions. In view of the vast geographical and socio-economic differences among different parts of the country. It is a huge country. You cannot have same geographical conditions everywhere. Therefore, you focus on different components also. Means special programs, incentives, strategies, focusing on different regions. And to develop those regions rapidly so that they become at par with the other regions of the country. And that is the best path of ensuring balanced regional development. I hope it is very simple. Again, I'm going very, very rapidly and very briefly for each type of planning so that you can understand. Then the next is target plan. Target plan means when within a plan, we have specific targets for the entire plan period, specific targets for different years of the planning, and specific targets for different segments of the planning also. Different sectors of the planning also. Suppose you have target for agriculture sector, you have target for industrial sector, you have target for service sector, etc. And resources are allocated in view of those targets so that ultimately we are able to achieve the overall target of the planning more effectively. That is known as target planning. And we have seen that right now. We had different targets for different plan period, different actuals for different plan period, etc. So we can have short-term target, we can have a medium-term target, we can have a long-term target. And I told you that day also, the difference between objective and target. Goal and targets are two different things. If you remember very well, I give you so many examples. Now, next is multi-level planning. In India, we adopted the multi-level planning in 1980s. And in multi-level planning, the base of the planning was district-level planning. District-level planning means district is the basic area of the planning, so that we can achieve the ultimate objectives of national plan. Why district level planning is the core of multi-level planning? Because people are more aware about their own districts. We have all records of agriculture, industry, services, business, etc. at district level record office. We are more familiar to district level authorities also. We are more familiar about the district level resources, geography, priorities, objectives also. District level planning makes the total planning of the state and the nation more effective and successful. And within district level planning, right now we have the planning for rural and urban areas separately within one district. That is, rural local bodies or panchayati raj institutions and urban local bodies, that is Nagar Palika, Nagar Nigam, etc. They formed their own planning and they are ultimately discussed at the district planning authority level and they are forwarded to the state planning authorities and that becomes the planning of the state and that is the part of the national planning. The multi-level planning actually is a district level planning which ultimately moves towards the national objectives of the plans. The base of multi-level planning is the district. Is it okay now? Because this question was asked, okay, what is the base of, or what means the district planning? Answer was, state level planning, commissioner level planning, district level planning, or the rural level planning? The answer is district level planning is the multi-level planning system. Now, next in Gandhian plan. Gandhian plan means the ideas of Mahatma Gandhi. Basically, there are so many components, but basically, rural self-sufficient economy, gramodyog, use of local resources, cottage industries, etc. Means all Gandhian ideologies are the core of Gandhian plan. Small scale industries, not big industries. Promotion of rural skills, rural endowments, local people, etc., etc. Handicrafts, handloom, all were the basis of Gandhian plan. Not industrialized, but the small level of local level of planning. That is basically essence of Gandhian plan. Then next is capitalist plan. Capitalist plan basically means the planning in capitalist system where market plays the dominant and decisive role, and role of the plan is to promote the freedom of the market profit is the main objective of the market, and the planning and government system helps to remove the obstacles of the market where public sector is very insignificant in total economic scenario. Private sector or the market is the most dominant in the economic scenario. And government role is to promote the public private sector or the market forces. Freedom of the market, freedom to the consumers, freedom to the producer is the main essence of the capitalist planning. And socialist planning is just opposite, where the socialism is the main ideology, where dominant role is that of public sector or the government. There is very small or insignificant share of private decision making, private sector, private ownership. And the ideology of socialism is a central force of decision making. And the zenith or the topmost level of social planning is known as communist planning, where all resources are under the government command and control. I have given a very, very rapid idea of all these terminologies. And if you have any question in any part or any important terminology, then you can ask me. Any discussion, any part that you think this is important?
Sir, please repeat again, what is the imperative plan, sir? I do not join, sir, in a time.
Now, first question is why you are late?
Sir, I was
Because
trying to
imperative.
join, sir, but I could not join.
Okay. Actually, imperative planning, I told you, imperative planning is also can be called as प्लानिंग बाय डायरेक्शन, प्लानिंग बाय ऑर्डर, प्लानिंग बाय कमांड एंड कंट्रोल, वेयर इट इज द सेंटर और टॉप मोस्ट अथॉरिटी हु डिसाइड द प्लानिंग एंड दैट प्लानिंग इज गिवेन टू एवरी सेगमेंट ऑफ द इकॉनमी एंड इट इज ऑर्डर ऑफ द टॉप मोस्ट अथॉरिटी दैट यू हैव टू ओबे फॉलो दिस प्लानिंग what has been decided by the topmost person. Basically, imperative planning is a planning of everybody to obey those orders by the topmost person at any level. Or hardcore ruler in Iraq, where one person rules and everybody has to follow. Got the point? That is called imperative planning. But this is not in practice right now. And for India, we don't have imperative. I always compare two words. What we have in India, not imperative, but indicative. Is it okay now?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. So sometimes the questions are asked, not in this exam, sometimes questions are asked in civil service also. Some important terms which is applicable for India and which is not applicable for India. Especially, I told you structural versus functional, centralized versus decentralized, indicative versus imperative, because they are opposite to each other. It cannot be same for both, same simultaneously for one country. It is not necessary that we ask the meanings, but they can ask the question based on the type of planning which in Indian context are applicable or not applicable. Is it okay now? You got the point. What is the importance of these terminologies also?
Yes, sir.
Okay, that should move forward. Let us move forward. Now something about, yeah. Had we discussed the Niti Aayog earlier or not?
No, sir.
Okay. Now, this is very important. Niti Aayog is very important from exemption point of view. Not for only for your this examination, but all examinations. Niti Aayog. And just to move toward Niti Aayog, I had discussed the Planning Commission and NDC. That are only the background because we don't have Planning Commission right now. We don't have NDC right now. The new system that was also a structural change. Structural change that even the structure of planning, decision making body also changed. Now I've given you here. I have placed you some very important dates and steps behind the setting of Niti Aayog. First, I have mentioned 29th May 2014. If you remember the year 14, it was the election year and it was new government at center led by Narendra Modi. You remember this. And in that time, we are discussing इंडिपेंडेंट इवेल्युएशन ऑफिस सबमिटेड एन असेसमेंट रिपोर्ट टू द प्राइम मिनिस्टर विद रिकमेंडेशन टू रिप्लेस प्लानिंग कमीशन. इट हैज गिवन सो मेनी पॉइंट फॉर रिप्लेसमेंट. आई एम नॉट डिस्कसिंग दोज, आई एम जस्ट कमिंग टू दोज पॉइंट ऑल्सो लिटिल लेटर. इट वॉज मे देन दैट असेसमेंट रिपोर्ट वॉज प्लेस्ड बिफोर द यूनियन कैबिनेट एंड ऑन 13th August 2014 यूनियन कैबिनेट स्क्रैप्ड द प्लानिंग कमीशन एंड डिसाइडेड टू रिप्लेस इट बाई सम न्यू ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इन प्लेस ऑफ प्लानिंग कमीशन. एंड इफ यू रिमेंबर और इफ यू इट माइट बी यू गेट सम इन सम बुक्स दैट इट वॉज 13th August 2014 एंड आफ्टर टू डेज ऑन 15th August 2014 when Prime Minister addressed to the nation, in that speech also, a speech from Red Fort also, Prime Minister mentioned that the Planning Commission will be replaced by some new organization very soon. That statement was made by the Prime Minister on 15th August 14 from Red Fort. Thereafter, on 7 December 14, the Prime Minister had a meeting with the state chief ministers to consider the structure of a new organization in place of Planning Commission. During this August to December, the paperwork was also going on to finalize the structure also, and that meeting was held on 7 December, when it was decided and approved the new structure. And after some days, next day was 1st January 15, that day after December, the cabinet resolution was made to set up a new organization called Niti Aayog. And for that, I have written a couple of points. The government has replaced, it was decided on the at cabinet resolution, in cabinet resolution written that government has replaced Planning Commission with a new institution named Niti Aayog. NITY means National Institution for Transforming India. Bharatiya Rashtriya Parivartan Sansthan. Abbreviation, we call it shortly Niti Aayog, and it was established through a cabinet resolution on January 1, 2010. I mentioned it here specifically so that you can understand that Niti Aayog was established through a cabinet resolution and not under the Constitution of India. Hence, it is also an extra constitutional body like Planning Commission, which I mentioned specifically that time. It is not a constitutional body. It is an extra constitutional body set up through a cabinet resolution. And it was said that the institution will provide governments at the central state levels with relevant strategic and technical advice across the spectrum of key elements of the policy. And last point I have mentioned, and what was the structural change? The last point you can see, an important evolutionary change from the past will be replacing a center to state one-way flow of policy to a genuine and continued partnership with the states. That is the concept of cooperative federalism also, where state will have a greater role to play in a combined manner for decision making and not in conflicting manner. It is not from center to states, but all states will combine together with the center to make decisions. Now, there is a very important thing to understand, that is allocation of business rules as revised on 24th March 2015. Whenever a new institution, a new ministry, a new department is set up by the government, it is also decided that what will be the functions, what rules will be applicable for this new organization. That is known as allocation of business rules, published by Cabinet Secretariat of Government of India, that clearly mentions the actions, activities, or business allocated to that institution, that body, that ministry, that department. Also here, Niti Aayog. The business rules said that Niti Aayog will have a 13-point agenda. I'm not discussing all 13 points, just mentioning very important so that you can understand the difference between Planning Commission, Niti Aayog specifically. Because many times this question is asked, even in interview boards, ki why Niti Aayog was set up and how it is different or it is similar, then you have to give your arguments and you have to establish that Niti Aayog is different and also better than Planning Commission. That should be your answer writing. You have to support Niti Aayog. Now I'm highlighting what are the main points to discuss so that you can understand difference between the Planning Commission and Niti Aayog specifically. I mentioned a couple of points here and we can discuss in length if you wish to. First point I mentioned, according to these rules, Niti Aayog is to offer a platform for resolution of intersectoral and interdepartmental issues in order to accelerate the implementation of the development agenda. Means if there is any issue, any question pertaining to intersectoral, means between the sectors or between the departments, then Niti Aayog will offer a platform to discuss and resolve the issues so that the developmental actions can be implemented more effectively to accelerate the growth and development agenda of the nation. Niti Aayog is supposed to play a role of a think tank to giving the new ideas, new strategies in context of emerging socio-economic challenges and situations and complexities. I think first bullet is clear to you. You ask the questions if you have any doubt and we can discuss again. Second point I have made, that in contrast to previous organization, that is Planning Commission, Niti Aayog will adopt a bottom-up approach rather than top down, where the decisions will be made at the grassroots level, and those decisions will plans will be made at the grassroots level, and those plan those decisions will aggregate to the higher levels, not vice versa, not top down, from bottom to top, and not from top to bottom. Aggregation of the plannings at village level, grassroots level, to the higher levels, from village to district, district to state, and state to nation. That is the bottom-up approach of Niti Aayog, as mentioned in the business rules. That is what I have mentioned in the third bullet also. What is bottom-up? That is, I have mentioned third point. The rules say the new institution intends to develop mechanism to formulate credible plans at the village level and aggregate those progressively at higher levels of the government. That is local government, district government, to state government, to national government, that is progressively reaching to the higher level. That is bottom-up approach. Next point is very, very important and totally different from planning commission. Fourth bullet, what I have mentioned, it says Niti Aayog will also ensure that economic policy focuses not just on growth, but also on national security. This is totally new dimension to the national planning. Within comma, what rules say? To ensure on areas that are specifically referred to it, that the interest of national security are incorporated in economic strategy and policy. If you remember, I don't remember whether we have discussed in length or not. If you look at the structure of any fire plan in any book, since first plan, 12 plans, try to look at any plan and see the areas covered under that plan, that fire plan, and see the resource allocation for different segments of the country, of the economy, within that fire plan. In every plan, you see total outlay means allocated amount of money for different sectors that become the total outlay. Suppose you allocate 10 rupees for agriculture, 5 rupees for irrigation, 5 for minerals, and so on. Then total outlay, this plus this plus this plus this. You understand my point, what I'm trying to say? In every fire plan, you can see total outlay. And that total outlay means total allocation of funds for different sectors of the economy. But if you have seen it seriously, you can say that outlay is allocated from agriculture to minerals to irrigation to industry to social sectors, education, health, etc., etc., etc. It will cover all the sectors except defense. Except defense. Have you ever noticed this?
Yes, sir.
If you go through any book and look at any plan, any fire plan, you will notice that total plan outlay covers all the sectors except defense. For difference, budget is allocated in our annual budget, but no amount is allocated in our fire plans. Can you tell me what was the reason behind this? Anyone? I'm repeating.
Sir.
Yeah, please, please.
Sir, because these are the areas which do not provide immediate returns.
These are the areas. Which are the areas? Which are the areas? Give me an
example. Sir, we are talking about. So we are talking about the defense now. The defense are the basically areas which do not provide the immediate returns. That's why we do not provide a financial means money we can't allocate at that time.
No, that is not the answer. That is not the answer. Suppose what you are saying, if I agree with you, suppose what type of returns are you talking about? When you say it is not...
Sir, basically... Yes, sir.
What returns you are talking about? Give me examples.
Just like we are talking about, तो हमें ऐसा होता है ना कि अगर हम किसी चीज पे इन्वेस्ट कर रहे हैं और उस टाइम कंडीशंस वैसे भी बहुत वर्स थी, हमारे पास उतना फॉरेन एक्सचेंज रिजर्व भी नहीं था कि हम उसे यूज कर.
प्लीज वन सेंटेंस. उस समय की बात हम नहीं कर रहे हैं, हम बात कर रहे हैं टिल 12 प्लान 2017 तक की बात कर रहे हैं. उस समय की बात मत कर रहे हैं हम. ये नहीं थोड़ी कह रहे फर्स्ट प्लान में ये था. हम कह रहे हैं पूरे प्लानिंग एरा में अप टू 2017, 12 प्लान को भी अगर आप देखेंगे, अपने पास कोई किताब होगी आप देखिएगा, जब प्लान को आप देखेंगे तो ये होगा प्लान आउटले 5 साल के लिए. टोटल प्लान में कितना हमने फंड सोचा है, आउटले, परिव्यय, हिंदी में कहते हैं परिव्यय, कितना पैसा हम खर्च करेंगे. तो उस पैसे को वो हर सेक्टर के लिए एलोकेट करते हैं, स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम एग्रीकल्चर टू सोशल सेक्टर. एजुकेशन भी होगा, हेल्थ भी होगा, एनर्जी भी होगा, हर सेक्टर होगा, डिफेंस नहीं होता है. मैं वही पूछ रहा हूं, ऐसा क्यों होता है? क्या डिफेंस एक इंपॉर्टेंट सेगमेंट नहीं है? तो डिफेंस के लिए प्लान में एलोकेशन क्यों नहीं होता था? मेरा मेरा सवाल सिर्फ यही है. और ये सवाल का बहुत अच्छे समझिएगा, बिकॉज यू नॉट गेट द आंसर इन द बुक्स. दैट इज आई एम आस्किंग क्वेश्चन, व्हाई नो फंड वाज एलोकेटेड फॉर द डिफेंस अंडर 5 ईयर प्लान्स. बाय 5 प्लान्स आई मीन अप टू 12 प्लान, नॉट इनिशियल 5 प्लान्स. नाउ यू अगेन, नाउ यू गिव योर आर्ग्यूमेंट प्लीज. Now tell me why, what are you thinking? You don't hesitate, just because when you speak out, then you can understand what are the shortcomings in your thinking and how can rectify those, so that you have a better perspective, better knowledge, understanding also. बताइए
सर. बेसिकली मैंने 5 ईयर प्लान्स में जब पढ़ा था तब मुझे उसका नॉलेज था. इन रिसेंट टाइम जो आप बात कर रहे हैं उसका मुझे नहीं पता कि व्हाई इन डिफरेंट सेक्टर वी आर नॉट गिविंग दैट थिंग.
नॉट वी आर, वी वर, नॉट आर. आई एम टॉकिंग टिल 2017, नॉट ड्यूरिंग नीति आयोग. आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट व्हाट हैपेंड ड्यूरिंग प्लानिंग कमीशन, एंड प्लानिंग कमीशन प्लान्स वर एप्लीकेबल टिल 2017, 2017 लास्ट प्लान 12 प्लान. बिकॉज आई वॉन्टेड टू जस्ट मेक यू मोर क्लियर, वॉट डू यू मीन बाई रिटर्न, दैट यू यूज द वर्ड रिटर्न. वॉट यू मीन बाई रिटर्न, दैट आई वॉन्टेड टू टेल यू. आप देखें इमीडिएट रिटर्न नहीं मिलता था. So what do you mean by immediate return? That I just want to make myself also clear, so that I can tell you what is the problem. बताइए आप क्या सोच रही हैं, क्या सोच रही हैं, उसमें क्या था, उसमें जिसका आपने कहा ना रिटर्न, तो उससे क्या मतलब है, आप क्या समझती हैं उसके, बताइए तो मैं उसको क्लियर करूं फिर आपको.
प्रॉफिट
चलिए।
देता सर।
हाँ तो बताइए, कुछ भी तो बोलिए, कुछ तो बोलिए, डोंट कीप साइलेंट। दैट इज अ ड्रॉबैक ऑफ ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड एंड स्पीक आउट। डोंट हेजिटेट, इट मे बी रॉन्ग, इट मे बी करेक्ट। इफ यू स्पीक आउट, इट मे मेक सम करेक्ट परसेप्शन फॉर अदर स्टूडेंट्स ऑल्सो हु आर नॉट स्पीकिंग आउट एनीथिंग। डोंट हेजिटेट,
सर बेसिक
बिकॉज
नीड्स से ज्यादा
बिकॉज
इम्पोर्टेंट है।
यू हैव टू स्पीक स्पीक व्हेन यू फेस इंटरव्यू। डोंट यू कांट कीप साइलेंस इन इंटरव्यू बोर्ड्स। सपोज आई यू आर फेसिंग इंटरव्यू बोर्ड, आई एम आस्किंग द क्वेश्चन। इफ यू कीप मम, इट मीन्स यू आर आउट ऑफ द इंटरव्यू बोर्ड। देन प्लीज जस्ट टेल यू व्हाट यू थिंक। आई एम हियर टू जस्ट टू मेक यू अवेयर, मेक यू करेक्ट। यस प्लीज टेल मी।
सर बिकॉज इन दिस ओनली द इंटर सेक्टोरल और इंटर डिपार्टमेंटल इश्यूज आर
No, no, no.
कवर्ड।
You are not getting my question. I am not talking about a Niti Aayog. I am talking about the simple question: when India had the system of five-year plans, that is the Planning Commission, then in each
Yes, sir.
five-year plan, funds were earmarked that they called outlay for five-year plan period, covering different sectors of the economy. Different activities for the economy, but in no plan you will find the funds allocated for defense. In no plan you will find. But I'm just simply asking you, what was the reason that funds were not allocated for defense under five-year planning system in India? That is my simple question. I'm not talking about what happened right now. Only then you can understand the contrast between planning and Niti Aayog. My question is pertaining to the five-year planning era in India, starting from first to 12th. That is simple. Plan system in India. If you have any further, please give me that so that I can make. Okay, let me
So there
then.
might be anybody who plans to do it.
There is nobody. There is no. I just mentioned you that for defense, the funds were allocated through budget, and through budget, funds were allocated for all the sectors, including body for defense only. Got my point? Now tell me, just what is the ultimate objective of agriculture in India? Agriculture, or any country, agriculture.
सेल्फ सफिशिएंट रहे खाने के।
No, we will be self sufficient, not self sufficient. That's the other question. Tell me why we are allocated, programs are made for agriculture. What is the ultimate objective of agriculture?
So because of the population,
Don't say
due
population.
to the
Don't say population. Ultimate of agriculture is to produce agriculture products. Simply, agriculture produces food, means the objective agricultural sector is to produce agriculture products, and agricultural products ultimately contribute to economic growth. Is it okay? Is it okay? Development and growth through agriculture. And you can add employment also, anything. But agriculture is to produce the items which are required for every, for industrial imports, for our consumption, etc. There are so many reasons. Number one is agriculture is supported to produce, number one. And ultimately, that production is part of GDP also. Growth also. Same question I can ask you. What is the ultimate purpose of industry? Please give me answer.
Sir, to give employment.
Simply to produce. Produce will include employment and service, everything. Again, to produce. Again, to
wide employment.
Oh, same growth. And when growth, you say growth, then means production, means when employment, everything is under the growth. Ultimately, production. Production means engagement of inputs, employment resources, employment, investment, technology, application, everything. We mentioned three sectors, agriculture, industry, and services, all ultimately aiming to contribute in economic growth of the country. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Now my question is, what is the ultimate objective of defense sector?
Protect
security, sir.
Yeah, now your answer. But that is it is not economic division, but our through services, Army, Navy, Air Force. Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Basic purpose of is to by different this is why the traditionally as a development. Defense was traditionally conceived as a developmental sector. All other sectors from agricultural services were considered as traditionally as developmental sectors. And defense was not covered under developmental plans of our country. It was a part of education through budget, but not through money. And for every amount allocated for expenditure in the budget is more, no difference. The expenditure, plan and non-plan, there are two components of agriculture of expenditure. There, under plan, we used to get agriculture, minerals, industry, energies, medical, education, everything. But under the plan expenditure, defense was not covered under plan. But also national security, that a very quotation I am mentioning to ensure on areas that are to it, that is international security, are incorporated in economic strategy and policy. Now, defense is also covered under the business rules of NITI Aayog. Defense was not mentioned under the business rule of planning commission. That is a very, very important and very significant difference between planning and NITI Aayog. That is, if I want to mention that, if I want to mention that right now, now we are having the and bomb 2B. 2B. 1B is bread, 1 is bomb. Bread and bomb balance. Bread and bomb strategy. Bread means agriculture to services is bread, and bomb means defense. To make a balance between bread and bomb is the main perspective of the NITI Aayog right now. That is bread and bomb. One more mention in this regard. The recent time of COVID, that is 3B, not 2B, but 3B, that is bread and bomb and breathe. Breathing, sans lena. That is health. Health, that is third dimension of B. So from 2B to 3B strategy, what we are right now, that is to ensure the bread and bomb strategy. Is it okay right now? Have you got some ideas about it?
Yes, sir.
Now,
Yes.
I would like to stop right now, and I would like to continue it on Sunday for only 1 hour. Only 1 hour, 8 to 9. If you are free, then you say yes. Otherwise, we'll meet on next Friday.
Yes, sir.
Are you
Yes, sir.
free?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Let's
Sure, sir.
go. I will discuss a little more. It is very, very important and very relevant right now. Because this is month of December 2021, and that is significant month for India, and it's 50 years of our 71 war also. And then on Sunday I will discuss something about this NITI Aayog, and then and our what I've talked about bread and bomb balance. And then I will also like to have one special class for you on defense also, hopefully in the month of December only. If you're available, then we'll have an extra special lecture for that part also,
Yes, sir.
especially in view of death and the
CDSC.
top level decision maker in the defense sector. That is very important. First Chief of Defense Staff, CDS. I will give you some idea about that also, and I have a special lecture next week. Next week after this Sunday. Will I come to that part also and announce that special lectures next week only? Okay. Then
Okay,
I'm
sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you,
conclude
sir.
here, and I will be again on Sunday at 8 o'clock in the morning to conclude the NITI Aayog structure. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Good, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.